Hello everyone and welcome to today's video. So I'm creating a video after a long time. I have taken a personal break and now I'm kind of back. As you might know, Stability AI just released SDXL Turbo, which is a fast real-time text-to-image version of its SDXL model, which was already impressive to begin with, and now they have a version of SDXL which is really fast and can actually create images in real time. So in today's video, we're going to see how you can actually run SDXL Turbo in your computers, and we're going to look at some of the advantages and benefits of creating images in real time and some of the issues that exist within SDXL Turbo. So SDXL Turbo is available for immediate use in comfyUI. So you need to install comfyUI. The easiest way to install comfyUI is go to the comfyUI GitHub page. And from there, you will find installing comfyUI and you'll find a direct link to download. So basically, it'll give you a zip file and all you need to do is unzip the zip file like I have done here. So this is my comfyUI installation, and inside comfyUI, you just need to click on run CPU if you don't have a GPU, but that is actually not recommended. If you have NVIDIA GPU, then obviously it's better to run it using run NVIDIA GPU. Now before running comfyUI, if you have already been running A1111 or any other user interfaces, then you might want to connect comfyUI to the model folder of that particular UI. So that's very easily done. So all you need to do is you need to go to the comfyUI folder, and over there you will find extra model path yaml.example. So you need to open this file. For me, I'm going to edit it with Notepad++. So I'm going to open it in Notepad++. So as you can see, you just have to copy and paste a path to the models folder, the LoRAs and everything else, the ESR gun and RealSR gun and embeddings folders from your other installation. For me, it was A1111. So I actually copied and pasted that. So this was actually this. So I had my checkpoints and configs in another drive. So I just copied the path of the drive. Basically just copy the path from here. So if you let's say basically if your models are here, then just copy it and paste the path here. So after that, you need to go here and delete .example and save it as just extra model path.yaml, and then automatically when you start comfyUI the next time, comfyUI will automatically configure all the paths and everything. So I've already done that for myself, so I'm not going to do it again. Also, if you downloaded the latest version, then everything should be updated. If it's not, then you can update it by going to this update folder here and just click on update comfyUI. Do not click on this update comfyUI and Python dependencies. It's not recommended. It's only for extreme situations. But for regular update, just click on this and it will update everything if you have an older version of comfyUI running. So when you've done all of that, you just need to go back and run comfyUI by clicking on run NVIDIA GPU. It's going to take some time, but it's going to load up the comfyUI user interface very soon. Now, of course, you need to download the special SDXL Turbo V1.0 checkpoint. So you can find that checkpoint in Hugging Face. I'll give you the link in the description. So from here, I downloaded the FP16 version, which I believe gives just the same quality. But if you have more space, or you know, maybe if you have a really powerful computer, then you can download the 13.9 GB version of it. I downloaded the FP16 Safe Tensor version and I pasted it in the models folder where all my other models were. Remember that I asked comfyUI to actually look at all my other models from a different installation, in this case A1111 installation. So make sure that you download your Safe Tensors file and keep it with the other Stable Diffusion models so that comfyUI can find that model from there. The final step is actually to download a workflow for SDXL Turbo, and I'll give you a link for that where you'll find lots of examples, and from there you need to download the SDXL Turbo workflow. So you need to click here and then just download this image. So this image actually includes the comfyUI workflow embedded within it, and all you need to do is download this image and drag and drop this inside comfyUI. So I have already downloaded it, and now I'm just going to show you how dragging and dropping it basically puts everything in place and you're ready to go. So now I am inside comfyUI default workflow. If you install comfyUI or if you're new to it, this is what you're going to do when you're running for the first time. And in order to load any workflow inside comfyUI, you need to just drag and drop the PNG image file or the JSON file, which is provided by the person whoever created this workflow. Over here, we have basically this SDXL Turbo workflow image, which is a PNG file. I'm just going to drag and drop it, and the workflow has been loaded. So basically this is the workflow. If your comfyUI is updated, then there shouldn't be anything missing. Everything should be there. and this is where you should find SDXL Turbo 1 model loaded. If you do not have it placed in the right place, then this might not load. So make sure that you have it in the models folder where you asked comfyUI to look at for all the other models. Now, when you fire it for the first time, it might take some time, and after that, it's pretty much like instant. I have a 3060 Ti with only 8 GB of VRAM, and I found that it's able to actually create images like really, really fast. But it takes some time in the first time, and if you want to go like real time, then you have to turn on, you have to click on these extra options, and you have to basically click on auto queue, which I'm not going to do now because I'm going to run the first instance and generate an image, and then from there you will see how fast it actually is. So let's just run the standard prompt that we have here. Might take some time, and after that it will be super fast. So as you can see, it's going to take some time, so we're going to wait for that first image to load. So as you can see, the first image has been generated. So now I'm going to just turn on auto queue and prompt, turn on queue prompting, and as you can see from the command shell that it's continuously looking for the changes in my prompt and looking to create the image. So I'm just going to change it from, let's say, jungle to desert, and it's going to pick that up pretty fast and try to change it to like a desert scene. Or let's say instead of fox, if I write a tiger, okay, it's going to try and detect that and pretty fast generate another image with a something else in the bottle. So because my screen recording is on, it's a little slow, but if I didn't have screen recording on, then it's actually much faster. It really does take around a second or so in my computer, which you have to be aware is kind of a mid-range computer. I only have 8 GB of VRAM and it's a 3060 Ti. Now there are a few things that I wanted to highlight. I'm just going to stop the queue now. Just a few things that you have to keep in mind, and one of the thing is that this is very fast because I think this is a version of SDXL which is trained in 512x512. So if I try to change it from 512 to 1024, I started getting some artifacts. So let's try this, and the image quality wasn't so good. So that told me that perhaps one of the reasons it's very fast is because it's designed to create images in 512x512 pixel. And when I go to 1024x1024, it's not as good with these images. So let's try this in a higher resolution and let's see. So as you can see, at a higher resolution, it's still very fast. It has created the image in 3.74 seconds, but it looks like the image quality is not so good because it is probably trying to create four different images instead of one 512x512. So this is one of the drawback, is that in order to make it fast, the developers have probably toned down the training quality to 512x512. Another thing is that there is an option to sort of change the CFG scale here, and there is another option. Let me just go to full screen now. So there is an option to change the CFG, and if you go to make it 2, then what do we get? So even if double the CFG, we don't necessarily get a good image. The problem continues to persist. So as you can see, it works best at a CFG scale of 1 only. So this is again something you have to keep in mind. And of course, it works best in 512x512 pixels. Another thing is that it also works best with only one step. I tried with 2 steps. Let's increase it to 2. And let's keep it to 512x512. And let's see what we get. So as you can see again, the image quality is not so good. So once again, the best CFG scale is 1, and the best step is actually also 1, and it will give you the best possible result. So let's try to generate another image. Let's try to generate a little bit complex image. It's a prompt I found in Midjourney. Make sure that our steps is 1 and our CFG is also 1, and the latent image size is 512x512. So basically, that's one of the issue, is that the image quality, in my opinion, is not as great as SDXL, because with SDXL, you get like a really great image. But the core advantage of SDXL Turbo is its insane speed. So if you wanted to run SDXL and you haven't been able to run SDXL in your computer or your laptop, then I think that this is something that you want to try. And one more thing, one thing about this workflow is that because it's designed to test for like fast changes, it doesn't save those images. If you want to save your images, for example, then you need to go here and see that it's actually not highlighted or it's kind of muted off. So you need to go here and mode and make it always, so it actually becomes active. And now if you try the prompt, it will actually save the file as well. So you should find it in, inside comfyUI, which is here. You need to go to comfyUI and you need to go to output, and it's already here. So guys, I hope you liked today's video. Please let me know how it went for you and your system. If you could generate SDXL images really fast using SDXL Turbo. And in the next video, we're gonna look at many other interesting and fun techniques that you can do inside comfyUI. And from now on, I'll try to regularly upload videos once every week. So please make sure that you hit the subscribe button and also the bell icon. So see you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.